For people who live with power, I don't think they understand how bad it is to be without power.
Meriam Sesiu is the head nurse at this remote clinic in the village of Manamaneng, Lesotho, that services over 6,000 people from 36 surrounding villages.
We have all kinds of patients coming for services. Every day we'll have pregnant women, TB patient, HIV patient, under 5, COVID screening, you name it.
This entire clinic is being run off a diesel generator, which is not fully operational and provides a largely unreliable and dirty source of power.
Once we don't have diesel, the generator is like a white elephant. The moment that system is not working, I cannot feel bad. I cannot lie. You are homeless. You are nothing.
This clinic in Lesotho is just one of thousands in sub-Saharan Africa that have no clean nor reliable energy sources. In fact, nearly 60% of all healthcare facilities have no access to electricity at all. Which is why the United States government, through USAID and Power Africa, awarded $2.6 million in grants to 9 solar energy companies to provide sustainable, clean, reliable, off-grid power to clinics across sub-Saharan Africa.
Power Africa initiated a health facility electrification grant as part of its redirection efforts towards the COVID-19 response. The purpose of the grant is to ensure that private companies install power in clinics so that they can operate at night.
Matt Oros is the chief executive officer of One Power, a Lesotho-based solar energy company that was awarded one of the 9 Power Africa grants.
To give you a quick overview of Lesotho, it's known as the Mountain Kingdom. It's very daunting terrain, but beautiful mountains, beautiful scenery. And most of the people in the country live off of a dirt road in a village in the mountains, pretty far from amenities and utilities like electricity and running water. So I thought if people get together as a team, as a company, you know, and kind of consolidate their efforts and their resources, maybe we can solve some of these challenges. And that's sort of the brainchild of how we formed One Power.
When the One Power team left the Lesotho capital of Maseru on a mission to bring power to Meriam's clinic in Manamaneng, they expected the journey to only take a day.
Our first reference was coming from Google Earth, but then Google Earth doesn't show you all the curves and everything about the road. It was not what we expected. There are some instances where they had to reverse and the passenger will be looking outside of the window and praying like, hey, we are almost at the edge, but thankfully they made it here.
One of the essential services offered at this clinic is maternal and child health care. Due to the nature of the terrain in Lesotho, many of the expectant mothers travel for days by horseback or by foot to get here and live for weeks before their delivery dates.
For them to stay here is better because they might deliver before the expected date of delivery. That is why we have got this functional wait mother's home.
Makubano arrived at the clinic a few weeks ago. She came alone to wait for the delivery of her first baby. This expectant mother's waiting room has no power at all, as the generator is not connected to this part of the clinic.
Hobani,
Meriam has been a midwife for almost 30 years, and she is famous in these parts for her compassion and the love she gives to all her expecting mothers and babies.
Klasi popoiki. Klasi popoiki.
Every day, she takes the expecting mothers out of the clinic and into the sunlight to dance and exercise, getting them mentally and physically prepared for natural labor.
Lerato leo o lefang bakudi ba hao ke lona le ntlafatsang qetello ya bogatshane ba bona.
This is Maritabile's second baby at the clinic, so she knows there's no reliable power at this facility.
Bota ka ntan ha swa ka o tlwele.
Ke ikutlwe ke sa tsaga ya handla a motla ka so gaoa. Ba ka nako nngwe e tlabe ba ke nako e motho o kulang o le matlhabeng. Jalo o ikutlwe tsamaya ka lefifi ka nako nngwe ga ona gona o tla gantsha ka.
When the battery is slow like this, most of the time it doesn't freeze the pig. And most of the time we are not using it because of that problem. We are struggling to have places where we can charge it. Ah, God. Sorry, my dear. It's unfortunate.
This ultrasound machine, which is an essential part of antenatal care, cannot be used regularly due to the unreliable power at the clinic. Although it is everyone's worst nightmare, deliveries at the clinic often have to take place at night, even though there is no electricity.
You know, it's challenging having a woman in pain and it's dark, but the baby says she wants to come out.
Ngai go tla ke tshile ha ho go pepela ka ga le fifi. Ho ba ne ke tla yentse ke batla ho bona ngwana.
Makopano's baby didn't come on this night, but the reality of using a single source lamp to light up the delivery room is very much a part of Miriam's life.
The solar lamp is the only rescue that we have. If the generator is not on or it can't be started, we resort to solar lamps, nothing else.
It was essential for Power Africa that One Power, together with all the other grant winners, had a sustainable business plan for every clinic installation.
We are promoting a market-driven approach where the customers actually pay for the electricity so that they feel a sense of ownership. With this grant, we're expecting that companies will come up with an operation maintenance plan that will go beyond the period of the grant and ensure that the systems continue to operate once the grant period is ended.
But One Power is a company, it's not an NGO. So basically we make electricity, we happen to do that with solar panels, and that's the revenue stream. So we make electricity and we sell electricity. We do it affordably and we do it in places where nobody else is able to do it. Those clinic systems right now are generating probably 2 to 3 times as much power as those clinics need. So the fact that we've got 2 to 3x more capacity in those clinic systems mean that we can connect dozens of houses and some schools to those containers. So the idea is to expand into the communities to additionally sell electricity to the surrounding villages. People have a variety of different methods to get energy into their lives, but all of those methods cost more than our mini grid plant.
USAID believes that the purpose of foreign aid is to end the need for its existence. Therefore, all these grants, not just the one in Lesotho, had to do more than just provide power to the clinics. They had to have an expansion plan that would aid in economic development for the surrounding areas.
Without power, communities are limited in what they can do. They cannot bring their dreams into reality.
We are contributing towards change. Change in a good way, in a sustainable way, and it's going to be something that is going to last beyond even our time.
After almost 7 days of non-stop work, Siema and the One Power team were almost ready to turn the lights on at the clinic.
We've already disconnected the clinic's old system. Definitely tonight we'll be energizing the clinic from our container.
Once the clinic has been switched over to the new One Power system, they will never be in darkness again.
Even though we are doing this under the name of the company, as individuals, we are also leaving a part of ourselves in each and every installation that we do. Okay, me. From today onwards, you'll be getting your power directly from the container.
No need to turn on the generator during the night. You can turn on the power so that you can see it coming on.
Yip, yip.
There you go.
Yip, yip. Yip,
yip. I'm running short of words. My heart is so touched. Day in, day out, timing the generator on, this level, the sound, really, it was hectic for us. Silent power is with us now.
Champion!